Hello everyone! My name is Tianlein, and today we talk about collectible skins in the Elder Scrolls Online, which you can acquire with in-game activities. We will talk about how the skins look like and where you can obtain them. Since ESO added so many new skins to the game, I thought it is time to make a new video about this topic. All the listed skins are obtainable via in-game activities, but for some you need to be able to access specific DLCs. Be aware that for many skins you need to complete really difficult content to unlock the needed achievements. Please take a look in the description if you are only interested in a specific topic. For the following two skins you need access to the Shadow of the Hiss DLC. Boss dungeons are not the easiest ones, and you need to complete multiple achievements to get these skins. To track your progress, you can find an achievement overview in your achievement journal. To acquire the Ember Plasm skin, you have to complete the Ruins of Mazatun Challenger achievement of the Veteran Ruins of Mazatun dungeon. For example, you have to complete the Veteran Ruins of Mazatun dungeon without suffering a group member death. Then you have to successfully complete a speedrun of the dungeon in Veteran difficulty and defeat all bosses in 30 minutes. Additionally, you have to defeat the dungeon bosses on Veteran Hard mode. The Spider-Kiss skin is obtainable in the Veteran Cradle of Shadows dungeon, and you have to complete the Cradle of Shadows challenge achievement. You have to accomplish a no-death run, a speed run, and defeat the last boss on hard mode on Veteran difficulty of the Cradle of Shadows dungeon. The Dreadhorn Shaman skin can be obtained in the Falkreath Hall dungeon, which is part of the Horns of the Reach DLC. For completing the Falkreath Hall challenger achievement, you will be awarded with the Dreadhorn Shaman skin. Here you have to complete the speedrun, a no death run, and also defeat the last boss in hard mode on veteran difficulty of the Falkreath Hall dungeon. The Black Marrow Necromancer skin is obtainable in the Veteran Scalecrawler Peak dungeon, and you have to complete the Scalecrawler Peak challenge achievement. You have to accomplish a no death run, a speed run, and defeat the last boss on hard mode on Veteran difficulty of the Scalecrawler Peak dungeon. The Scalecrawler Peak dungeon is part of the Dragonbones DLC. The Sableman Beast skin is obtainable in the Moonhunter Keep dungeon, which is part of the Wolfhunter DLC. For completing the Moonhunter Keep Challenger achievement, you will be awarded with the Sableman Beast skin. You have to complete the speedrun, a no death run, and also defeat the last boss on hard mode on veteran difficulty of the Moonhunter Keep dungeon. If you own the Imperial City DLC, you can try to acquire the Soul Shriven skin. Don't forget that the Imperial City and the Imperial City Sewers are a PvP area. This skin can be found in the center of the Imperial Sewers, the Baratrum Centrata. In the center of the room are three portals, which spawn random Sifkin generals during the final wave. After you closed all three portals, the boss, a simulacrum of Molag Bal, will be summoned. There's a very rare chance to get a Soul Shuffle skin by defeating the simulacrum of Molag Bal. It's important to note that a maximum of 12 players can earn the event reward. That means when you fight with more, that some people will get nothing from the boss. The Christopher skin is obtainable during the New Life Festival. Usually the New Life Festival is active mid of December until the end of December. You have to complete 12 New Life Festival rites to unlock the newly charitable achievement and earn the Christopher skin. To receive the following skins, you have to complete specific trials on Return difficulty. Not only that you need to find a group of 12 people to be able to complete these trials, you also have to keep in mind that these Return trials are one of the hardest contents in the Elder Scrolls Online. To be able to obtain a Dromata skin, you need to have access to a Thief Skill DLC. If you complete the trial Maw of Lokai on Return difficulty, you will be rewarded with a Dromata skin. The next skin can be obtained in Wardenfell. You need to have access to Morrowind to be able to visit Wardenfell. If you successfully complete the trial Halls of Fabrication on Veteran Mode, you will be rewarded with the Fabrication Sheet. In the Clockwork City DLC, you have the opportunity to obtain the Sanctified Silver skin. You have to successfully defeat the bosses Saint Olms and his allies Saint Lotus and Saint Thelms in the trial Asylum Sanctorum on Veteran difficulty. Only when you fight and defeat all three bosses at the same time, which is the hardest configuration of the trial, you will earn the Sanctified Silver skin. The next skin can be obtained in Somerset. You need to have access to Somerset to be able to enter the Cloudwest Trial. Smarja's Shadow skin is awarded for completing the Cloudwest Vanquisher achievement. This achievement is awarded for defeating all bosses in a single fight in Cloudwest at Veteran difficulty. The next skin can be obtained in Mirkmire. You need to have access to the Mirkmire DLC to be able to enter the Black Rose Prison Arena. The Marsh Mist Payscale skin is awarded for completing the Black Rose Prison Conqueror achievement. I hope you enjoyed my overview of all collectible skins in the Elder Scrolls Online. Thanks for watching, and it would be wonderful if you subscribe, like, or leave me a comment. Have a good day, and until next time, tschüss!